In this year's Lakeshore County Pumpkin Pie Bake Off.
Here we go. Love the pie.
I just realized that I never wished you good luck. Probably because you don't really mean it. Look, I was going to tell you, Faye, tell me what? That we've thrown all our plans in the garbage and you're going to open a bakery without me? It was my father's decision. It's his money, Faye, and he wanted to gamble on me, alone. Sure, after I've taught you everything you know. You haven't even had a cooking lesson. If it wasn't for me, you'd still be using pre-made cookie dough. How dare you? It's been years since I've used that stuff.
Yeah, right.
Well, you only had one win.
Pre-made cookie dough.
This wasn't my call. If I won this space on Fuller Street, I had to accept his offer immediately, even if it meant stabbing me in the back.
Okay, ladies. Let's leave the knives in the food, please.
Looks like we may have to cancel our golf game tomorrow.
You kidding me? Looks like it might be canceled permanently.
Yeah.
Faye, please, you're my best friend. We never made definite plans. It was all just a pipe dream.
Oh, so that bedlam I liked, but that was just a pipe dream.
I'm sorry about that. I am.
Don't be.
Really. I don't need you, Lydia. I'm going to open my own bake shop. Right, Reggie?
Yeah.
And for your information, I already have a line of credit, a lifetime of recipes, and this here trophy, which I'm going to display prominently in the front window of my new bakery. Are you sure you want to go head-to-head with me, Faye? Is that a threat? It's a dare. Well, I guess this is war.
Take care, Rich.
Take care, Max.
Budget. I need to take a look at some of these line items.
Casey, I don't know what any of this means.
That's why I've got you.
Well, it means if we cut a few of these specialty items off the menu, we could come out of the red.
Maybe. I hope. I'm also developing a new advertising marketing plan for us.
And how much is that going to cost?
I promise I'll be conservative.
Well, if we get the Buckeye Hotel account, we may not have to worry, right? We'd be baking a lot of pastries for a lot of continental breakfasts.
Well, yeah, of course, but I can't budget based on what-ifs. I'm figuring this out from a strategic standpoint. You just focus on the baking.
Speaking of which, come. I want you to sample the front runners for this year's bake-off.
Thanks.
That's why we're in trouble, you know? In the past, profits soared every time I won. But now, losing 3 years in a row to that traitor Lydia Harper... I bet her bakery is booming.
I know, but this is your year. I can feel it. And I promise you, we're going to turn the ship around.
From your lips to God's ears, honey.
about 350 yards there. He's got a 7-iron and, yeah, he's looking slightly.
What are you doing here so late, Case?
Oh, I just came to check up on her again.
She's resting. The medication's helping the physical pain, but the mental pain is another matter entirely.
Did they really say 6 weeks off her feet?
Could be longer if it doesn't heal right. Just pray she doesn't need surgery.
Oh, I should fix that step sooner.
Come on. You both had a lot on your plate.
Well, I already arranged for a substitute baker for the morning, but that's all we can afford now.
Unless you want to take on some of the baking. Of course, we all know what happened the last time.
All right, well, I'll just focus on working on that hotel account, and the new baker can focus on cooking until Mom's back on her feet. I have it all figured out.
Not all of it.
Oh, no. The bake-off.
Yep.
Oh, that's not good. What are we going to do?
You're the public face of the sweet factory now. You're going to have to do it in her place.
Oh, you're serious?
Why not? You're a smart girl. You got a 4.0 at Wharton.
Dad, I almost burned down the store.
Case, you didn't burn down the store. And furthermore, I believe in you.
I don't believe in me. Not when it comes to the kitchen.
Go talk to your mother. See what she thinks. And stop worrying. We'll insure it if you burn down the place.
Cute, Dad. Really cute. You want to enter the bake-off?
No, but someone has to.
I'm just going to have to do this myself. We have no choice.
No. You were saying? You have to stay off that ankle. You can't stand for an hour baking.
But we have to win this thing, Casey. Our business depends on it.
Look, maybe it's not so bad. The bake-off is a centerpiece for the Harvest Festival. Everyone pays attention. But it needs a new story. I mean, your big feud with Lydia Harper is hardly a feud if she keeps winning.
And that story is you?
Me going up against her? That'll get people talking about a place.
Okay, I'm listening.
Look, Grandma passed all her recipes on to you, right? But you get to pass this on to me. The circle of life. And maybe we get some free press out of it. Come on, Mom, let me try. For the bakery. For us.
Okay, for us. We've got enough insurance, so...
Why does everyone keep saying that? It's not funny.
I'm just kidding. But seriously, you need to beat Lydia Harper. Because all this publicity you've been talking about, it may help our business with some tourists. But winning the bake-off will bring in the locals.
Okay. I can do that.
Good.
Don't get my mom. She will not be able to resist my signature mac and cheese with ham and gruyere.
Sam, she said no 100 times already.
Maybe 101 is the charm.
Ah, that time of the year already, is it?
All these years, and you're still having someone sneak you Faye McCarthy's pumpkin scones?
I hate myself for liking them so much. I've tried to recreate this recipe a dozen times.
Well, I have something delicious that'll take your mind off that.
I already told you, Sam, we are not expanding the menu.
Is this or is this not our business?
It is our business, but I'm still in charge.
Look, Mom, you've won the bake-off 3 years in a row. Why not ride the wave? We can have a full-service restaurant by the end of the year.
This place couldn't handle that kind of volume.
So we build a second story. Or buy the place next door.
Oh, that sounds a lot like expanding, and we do not have the money for that.
We apply for a loan. It'll pay itself off in no time. What's your favorite expression?
Create something unique for yourself.
Yes. And right now, you and Faye McCarthy are like two sides of the same coin. Don't you want to be more than her?
Of course I do. I always do.
Then this is how you take it to the next level.
I'm sorry, Sam, but it's just not financially feasible for us.
Well, then maybe I need to reconsider my future here, because I didn't spend 2 years at the Cordon Bleu in London to make banana cupcakes and lemon bars for the rest of my life.
Hello, how are you? How's your day?
Wow, only 17.
Okay, I know that look. What have you heard?
That Faye McCarthy broke her fibula or tibia or something, and she has to stay off her foot for more than a month. So, Casey McCarthy is entering the bake-off in her place. She does the books.
Great. So it'll be an easy win for you.
Actually, it's going to be an easy win for you. Mm-hmm. I am passing you the torch, son.
What if I refuse the torch?
You can't refuse the torch. It's your birthright.
I don't think it is. Look, Mom, I really don't want to take on your feud with Faye McCarthy. Besides, it's not even Faye. It's her daughter.
Think of the publicity. The Harper-McCarthy feud moves to the next generation. Plus, it's no fun for me if I don't get the satisfaction of beating Faye.
Mom, it's a pumpkin pie contest.
No, Sam, it is the pumpkin pie contest. The TV news covers it. The paper, the final round is featured on the culinary channel show Pie Heaven. And you know what happens every time last year's episode airs.
We run out of pie.
We run out of everything. Sam, I know we've been having some disagreements lately, but it's important to me.
Okay, fine. I'll do it. Then you have to do something for me.
What's that?
I'm going to put together some sort of presentation, a business plan for our restaurant, and you will consider it. It's important to me.
Okay. It's a deal.
Great. Let's talk pumpkin.
It's important you wear your game face at all times. In this competition, they prey on your weaknesses. The dog eat dog rule, and that is nothing compared to the bake-off. Every eye in town is on you, watching. Be careful what you say. Be careful what you do. There's no room for error. There's no room for error. Excuse me. Excuse me. It's like the Hunger Games. I don't know what that means, but I'm sure this is worse.
All right. Save it for the big show. So we all know the rules. There's two rounds of judging. Round one, all 12 contestants will pick their very own loaf of gourmet pumpkin bread. Our three judges will then choose three winners. For round two, our finalists will bake an original pumpkin pie. Seen it all before, folks. Let's please try and be extra creative this year, all right? What's the best thing to put into a pumpkin pie?
Your tea!
Now, please, form a single file line at the table to register.
Hey, I didn't know I'd be going up against Sam Harper. There was nothing that guy wasn't good at in high school. I mean, we weren't friends since your war with Mrs. Harper.
Well, that doesn't seem to have ruined your life, dear.
Well, I guess not, but he's a professional chef. He does all the baking for Fuller Street. I can't compete with that.
Yes, you can. And with any luck, mediocrity runs through his Harper veins, and you've got my blood running through yours.
And I'll teach you everything I know. No way, Mom. Absolutely not. The doctor said that foot has to heal. Besides,
I have to learn how to run things on my own sooner or later. There's Eleanor Field. I'll go talk to her about her granddaughter's birthday cake.
Anyway, I'll see you back at the car.
Okay.
Hey. Oh. Sam Harper?
Casey McCarthy? I haven't seen you around town lately.
Oh, we McCarthys like to keep a low profile.
Ah, of course. I want them to keep their secret recipes hidden from my family.
Exactly. So how's business on your end?
What do you want to know?
Nope. Just trying to be cordial. Ours is killing it, by the way.
The fact that you feel the need to tell me that makes it sound a little questionable.
Oh, feel free to think what you want. Wouldn't want to burden you with actual facts.
So? Are you ready? This thing can get ugly, you know.
Of course it will. It's the world-famous bake-off, after all.
Well, seriously, Casey, you don't actually think you can beat me, do you? I mean, I've been doing this thing since high school.
Okay, sure. Maybe I don't have your culinary training and all your years in the kitchen, but where I come from, we're taught to think outside the box. And fortunate for me, outside the box is where I live and breathe.
We're pretty confident, aren't we?
That's right. I can't wait to see your face when this rookie takes first place in front of the entire town.
Game on, Miss McCarthy.
Come on, Mr. Harper.
Thank you.
their mixes. Oh, well, you didn't say that.
Well, I thought it was a given. You did grow up in a bakery.
Yes, and I've watched you do this a million times. So can you please go home now? I have to practice, and I don't need to worry about you hobbling around here.
Okay. Oh, I forgot. Your sister's coming to town early to help us out with the festival.
Great.
Do you want to come to the house early tonight? Just to discuss strategy? For your pitch meeting with the Buckeye Hotel?
Yes, yes. Now, can you please go home? Dad's been waiting for you in the car for the last 15 minutes.
Just keep practicing. You'll be okay.
Hey, Mom, can you come in and get this? It says I need a baking pumpkin, and I don't know what that means. They all look the same to me. Okay, bye. Isn't a pumpkin just a pumpkin?
Actually, no, it's not. I'm surprised you don't learn that at the bakery you run with your mother.
Well, as you know, I tend to the business end of things. She bakes. It's a perfect partnership.
But you're the one entering the bake-off. And you don't know the difference between a carving pumpkin and a baking pumpkin?
I do. I own a bakery. It's just that my specialties lie elsewhere.
Like, on a spreadsheet?
I have many other talents.
I'm listening.
Oh, you think I'm going to show you all my cards?
What, you think you're holding the royal flush?
I just might be. So I suggest you fold now to avoid embarrassment.
I never fold.
Oh, this is good. We're just carrying on an age-old family tradition. Harpers versus McCarthy's.
It's heartwarming, isn't it?
Yeah, I can't wait to see how it plays out.
Ditto. Good luck finding your baking pumpkin.
Trust me, luck has nothing to do with it. So, what's a baking pumpkin? Maple scones? Oh, and croissants. Every hotel has croissants for breakfast.
I'll have it all ready for my meeting with them on Wednesday.
And stop worrying. I'll knock it out of the park.
Okay. See? I can handle the business and the contest. I can't believe Sam Harper thinks I don't know what I'm doing in the kitchen.
Honey, you don't know what you're doing in the kitchen.
Yeah, but he doesn't know that.
Just be careful, okay? I know he's cute and charming, but he is his mother's son. And she's a snake in the grass.
Mom, I have a business degree from Wharton. I mean, we had entire classes on psychological warfare. I think I can handle the likes of Sam Harper. Besides, this is our family business, and nothing is more important to me.
That's my girl.
That tastes like cement.
So you found yourself a baking pumpkin.
Yes, Captain, there will not be a third time. Please take this back to the guys at the station. On the house. You're doing great work. So, now you know. I'm a complete disaster in the kitchen.
I just want to make sure you're okay.
I'm fine. The bakery's fine. And as much as it might disappoint you, we will live to see another day.
Contrary to what you might think of my family, we really don't want anything bad to happen to your business. In fact, it's nice having the competition. It keeps us on our toes. To be honest with you, I'm even sort of looking to get out of the whole bakery business altogether.
Really? And do what?
A full-service sit-down restaurant. That would serve a family-friendly American classic cuisine with a gourmet flair. Full street restaurant. We'll just take a few renovations, new space maybe.
So what's the holdup?
My mother, of course. I want her to think bigger, but she's so concerned about the time, the energy, the money. But more than anything, I think her whole life is focused on the bakery. I guess she worries a restaurant might interfere with it.
Well, I hope you can convince her. That way, people would only come here for pastries and all my problems would be solved.
So things aren't going so...
We're getting by.
We've been as well. But I want to do more than just get by. My mother and I have an agreement of sorts. I win the contest and she'll consider the proposal.
What kind of proposal?
Right now, it's just a menu for the restaurant, but I'm working on the business plan, which is taking a little longer.
The most important thing I learned at Wharton was the difference between an idea and a plan. Dreamers have ideas, and doers have plans. Best advice I can give you is map out every last detail, from start to finish.
Thanks, I'll do that. So what about you? What's your recipe for the preliminary round? An idea or a plan?
Well, first there was an idea, then it was a plan, and now it's bordering on colossal failure.
Look at us. What a pair.
Wait a minute. I got it. You need a viable business proposal, something I can do in my sleep. With my mother out of commission, I need someone to teach me how to bake without burning down the town.
You want me to help you win?
No, just help each other get what we both want. Did I mention I was top of my class? Do you know how many job offers I had after graduation?
Feels a lot like conspiring with the enemy.
I won't tell if you don't.
All right, you got yourself a teacher.
So, 10 o'clock at night. But text me first to make sure I'm alone. My mother's failing miserably at staying off her feet.
Got it.
We have to be very careful, Sam. I don't know about your mother, but mine will practically disown me if she has any idea that we're helping each other out.
Oh, trust me, my mother would as well.
Okay, I'll see you at 10.
Big sister. And you're here.
Again.
What? The baker filling in for me called with some questions, so I had Betty drive me over.
She insisted, and I was just home working on my bake-off recipe. I just might have a shot this year with Faye and Lydia out of the mix. Between those two, no one else has won that contest in well over a decade.
Well, that definitely changes this year.
Yeah, maybe we can get some other things to change this year, too.
It's no use, Betty. I tried. They're the Hatfields and McCoys of Emeryville.
Is it too much to ask to want to have my good friends back together again?
Yes. And you know very well, Mother, that you can answer questions over the phone.
Oh, I'm so bored at home. Why can't I come in and help?
Because the doctor said if you keep standing on that foot, you might have permanent damage.
That's why. Now go home.
Oh, all right, fine. I know when I'm not wanted.
Silence.
Fine, honey.
Oh,
come on, Betty. So,
I have taken the week off work. I am all yours. Although I may have to do a little work while I'm here because I'm a big case coming up next month.
Thank you so much. You have no idea how much I need you this week.
Oh, are you kidding? You and Sam Harper taking over the family feud? I would not miss this for the world.
We're not taking it over. We just both happened to enter the bake-off for the first time this year. That's all.
Yeah, but Mom says if you win this, that you're going to get featured on that culinary show, Pie Heaven. That's pretty cool.
Well, don't set your DVR quite yet. I'm a long way off from winning anything.
Casey, you do so much for this place. You know you don't have to take on this contest as well.
You remember after I graduated, I could have moved away to work at that big company in New York?
Mm-hmm.
I had a choice, but Mom needed me. So the choice was easy. I guess deep down, I really do love this place. And that's for that very reason I do need to take this contest on.
I'm glad you're here. I wish you a lot of
luck. Mom's driving me crazy.
I believe it.
Now, stir it in with the cinnamon, nutmeg, cloves, and ginger. We'll do each mix separately and then blend them together.
Okay. Got it. I think.
Cooking should be entered into with abandon, or not at all. Julia Child said that.
If you're not going to take it seriously, get out of the kitchen. Faye McCarthy said that.
So how is he grew up in a bakery and never learned to cook?
I've always had more of a propensity towards business and academics. That's why I'm the brains of the sweet factory and my mother is the brawn.
Okay, Miss Academic, try this. Treat the recipe like an equation, follow the steps, and it won't steer you wrong.
Actually, though, I think cooking is more of an art form. And Art and I, we've always had this love-hate sort of thing.
Just takes practice. You're good. Now stir!
But you, on the other hand, you're the star quarterback. Went to work for your mom right after high school. Went off to culinary school in France.
Almost to 350 degrees. Let's mix the pumpkin.
So how did you know this is what you wanted to do?
My grandma used to say, you want to show someone you care, cook for them, so that's what I do. Sometimes a plate of chocolate chip cookies is all you really need. And while the bakery's been great, it's time for a restaurant, something with community tables where it's loud and busy and food is served family style. Now that is the perfect way to mix if you want your bread to be clumpy and uneven. Is that the texture you're going for?
Of course. Who doesn't like clumpy bread? Okay, you go ahead. You show me the right way.
Use this.
Okay.
In a circle. Like this. Look at that. That was a single clump.
Yeah.
I'm a pretty good teacher.
From Harvard.
Hopefully not too good, though. So when are we going to talk about my business plan?
Tomorrow night. I promise. Well, let's call it a night before I collapse. Let me guess, she sent you to spy on me?
Actually, no. I'm about to play 18 holes of golf. I made some snacks and, for the guys. Don't tell your mother, but Lydia's white chocolate macadamia nut cookies are better.
Bite your tongue, Dad.
I'm dead to the case.
Did you tell him about all the different flavors we offer seasonally?
This is not my first rodeo, Mom. I told him everything we discussed, and there was not a single onion pastry at the
table. Yes! Great. So, what's next?
Well, they're talking to a few other people, but I feel like we have a really good shot.
That's wonderful, Casey.
You have nothing to worry about.
I've got this.
Over. I need a sugar fix.
Okay, yeah. I'll put some in a to-go box for you.
Ready to have my cupcakes, okay?
Gosh, Casey, you've been working so hard. Why don't you go home? I can close up.
No! No, I have another practice run in the oven, and maybe this one will be successful. I'll keep you posted.
You don't have to prove yourself to me. You know I'm way worse at this than you are. Was that Sam Harper?
What?
Where? He just tried to walk in here.
No, really? Are you sure? You sure it was him?
I don't know.
I don't know.
Sorry about that earlier. I couldn't get my sister out of here.
It's okay. I had to catch up on my window shopping anyway.
So, where were we? Construction and renovations estimate here. Monthly rent increase, operating expenses, staff, insurance, etc.
Wow, you've thought of everything.
This is the difference between an idea and a plan.
You're really good at this. So tell me, have you ever been tempted to call that company back in New York?
Maybe once, after some silly argument with my mom. But then I realized how much I love it here. And I grew up in this place. Someday, my kids are going to be here, doing their homework, eating donuts. This is home.
I love the feeling.
But hopefully this puts you one step closer to your dream. I mean, after I win tomorrow, you're going to need to take things in a new direction. A fallback plan, so to speak.
I wouldn't be so sure of yourself, McCarthy. You still haven't seen my recipe for prelims.
I haven't. What? I had a pretty good practice run today, so you better bring your A game.
All I have is an A game, McCarthy.
Well, then I'll just say good luck.
And to you, may the best man...
Or woman!
Or woman! Win.
Give you some very sound, unsolicited advice. When I first started college, what was my major?
Pre-med. But if I remember correctly, the set of blood made you faint.
Every single time. In theory, I love medicine. But in practice, it made me unconscious. So I changed course.
Yeah, to law.
Exactly. It just spoke to me, and then I ended up loving it. You need to find what speaks to you.
Yeah, but I already know. It's this place, the bakery. That's what speaks to me, and I just really want to do what's right by it.
And let that fuel you. And let go. And have a little fun with it.
Wait, cooking's supposed to be fun?
Yeah. Why didn't anybody tell me that?
Casey. Thanks again for helping me out. Went over in detail last night. Business plan's incredible.
Well, just don't tell anybody where you got it.
Secret safe in there. But more importantly, how are you feeling?
I'm fluctuating between terrified and being completely numb. So, all in all, not bad.
I'm running a truth.
Okay, stop being nice to me. People are looking.
We should probably give them what they want.
It wouldn't make it worth the price of admission. Let's do this.
Really think you're going to fly? Don't kid yourself, Casey.
Okay, what do you want here, Penny? I'll ask for it. You know everything. I've taught you everything.
Oh, you don't need my opinion. You know you're going to lose.
You believe this guy?
It's never too late to throw in the towel, McCarthy.
That's okay. Why don't you keep it? Because it looks like you're the one who's sweating. Are you two going to be doing this the whole time? Oh, sorry.
Thank you. Thank you. All right, everyone. We're ready to begin the preliminary round. Throughout the day, contestants will prepare their dishes in groups of three right before your very eyes. Our 10 a.m. group has taken their places. That's 60 minutes. No exceptions. And the clock starts now. Please present your dishes.
Sweet Factory's very own pumpkin bread, fresh from the oven.
Fuller Street Cafe's very own pumpkin bread. Cool to perfection.
Gail's very own pumpkin bread, fresh and hot for you.
Outdone yourself, Monsieur Gail. Okay. At the end of the baking round, we'll see if these dishes have what it takes to move on in the competition. 11 a.m. contestants. We'll be back in 15 minutes.
When your mom comes back with our drinks, don't tell her I let you. you had cotton candy before lunch.
Is this a private party, or can anybody join?
I don't think that's such a good idea. You know, the walls have eyes around here.
You did great this morning.
Really? Oh, I don't know. I think I forgot an ingredient. I got so nervous with everyone just staring.
I think you gave them a good taste of what's to come at finals.
You mean the famous family feud?
They're practically salivating. Never underestimate this town's desire for some juicy gossip. Be proud of you, McCarthy. Bye.
Casey? What did he want?
He just wanted to wish me luck. Huh. You okay?
So what are these doctors saying?
Well, just two more weeks on these things.
On those things or off those things?
Okay, he still wants me to take it easy. And I was going to miss the prelims.
Well, Mom, why don't you go sit down? I'll bring you your food.
All right, fine.
So I graciously handed over the reins this year. What can I say? He's my son and one of the...
Letting someone else take center stage, Lydia? Are you feeling okay, or should somebody call an ambulance?
Hello, Faye.
I just heard. Baker's in trouble. I just want you to know that I feel for you. You've come a long way from ready-made punk ghosts.
All right, that's it!
Oh, Faye! Mom, come down.
Yeah.
Let's get away from all this trouble.
Yeah, Mom, let's go. Come on. Wait, where's the kettle corn?
You ate it?
Well, not all of it.
Ate it?
Well, why did you get the extra large?
My bad.
There has to be something we can do to stop this fighting between our mothers. Having to hide this forbidden friendship is starting to get old.
Is that what we have? A forbidden friendship?
You make it sound so illicit when you say it like that.
I don't know. It's kind of fun having a secret with you.
But if I don't make finals, then what?
And I don't know.
You go back to being a Harper, and I go back to being a McCarthy, where we happily coexist in perfect disharmony.
That doesn't sound like very much fun.
No. Fine. I don't just want to go to finals. I want to win.
Me too.
Good luck, Sam. I really mean it.
I love you, Sam. But not really. Ow! Oh, careful with my steering arm.
Thank you. All right. As promised, sports fans, only three. Our 12 contestants will be moving forward. Our first finalist, Group 3, a rookie, comes from a champion's bloodline in this competition. A legacy, if you will. Sam Harper of the Fuller Street Bakery. Our next finalist, from Group 1, someone who has yet to take home a title after 9 years of competing, Betty Lund.
This is my hairstyle.
And our third, last finalist, another rookie who shocked us all with this freshman entry, Casey McCarthy of the Street Country. A new generation of Harpers and McCarthys going head-to-head in an unbelievable showdown. It's going to be one of the most exciting final rounds we've ever seen at this competition. Hold on tight, everyone, because 4 days from now, we will have a new Pumpkin Pie Champion!
You should be proud of yourself, why aren't you happy?
I am happy. I was just thinking that only one of us can win. Come on. If I win, what does that mean for you?
Well, I do have this spectacular business plan that if my mom can't see the potential, then maybe some investors can.
If you win, I think that could be really bad for our family business, especially if you don't land this hotel account.
You still haven't heard back from them yet?
No, nothing. I was really hoping we would, so I didn't have to go up against you.
Don't you realize we're part of a family feud? You're supposed to despise me.
I know. You're supposed to be the competition in every sense of the word. Little do they know that it was you that helped me get into finals. Well, you and my mother's recipe.
You got you to finals. I was just the coach.
Does that mean you're not done yet? Because right now, I only know how to make one dish, and it's not a pumpkin pie.
As far as I can see, we can either help each other or hurt each other.
Okay. I can help you do a 5-year projection plan to further entice your mother.
Tomorrow night at 10 at the bakery. I'll bring her.
To the bank. I mean, lessons. Let's go.
You know what night this is, right? And he goes, yeah. God, you know who's coming.
Casey! Betty was just telling me the funniest story about her son, Jake. You remember Jake?
Yeah. He's single. And he has a boat.
Oh, that's great for him.
Why did you take the night off, honey? Your sister and I can close. You've been working so hard, you need to take a break.
Oh, yeah. That sounds... I'd love a night off.
You're so lucky to have each other and this wonderful business. My kids, well, I don't hear from them much. I'm so
Did somebody order some pumpkin moon pie?
Hey, you read my mind.
It's my superpower. Not to mention Mom told me to drop them by on my way home.
Oh, you want to stay for dinner? I could microwave something marginally edible.
Well, that does sound enticing. No, I can't. I have to go home and practice my pie recipe. I think I'll be at it all night.
Are you using your mother's recipes?
No, I came up with one on my own. Want to hear it?
Yeah.
Pumpkin silk chiffon pie with bourbon whipped cream.
Can't wait to try that. Did you run it by your mom?
No, I sort of want to surprise her. I want to show her that I can do this on my own. I mean, she's so incredible in the kitchen, and if this is my business too, then I want her to know I can cover for her if she ever needs me to.
I have to tell you, honey, I'm really proud of you, making it all the way to the final round.
Well, I haven't made a pie yet, so don't be too proud. I'm still a work in progress.
I'm getting better every minute. No, go make that pie. And save me a piece.
I will. I love you.
Love you too. This would be year 5-year?
Yes, and I would be concerned with an estimated 8 to 10% growth year over year.
Then, minus yearly operating expenses? Makes a nice profit, look at that.
You got it. You just created a 5-year projection plan. So it's not complicated, you just follow the formula and it never fails you.
You really light up when you talk numbers.
That's my language. No mistakes.
True. But mistakes aren't always a bad thing. Sometimes they lead us to what we've been looking for all along. It's how I came up with my fried mac and goat cheese appetizer. And now it's going to be the signature dish on my menu.
Now that sounds delicious.
You have no idea. And that would mean your very first pie crust is ready.
This is supposed to be solid, right?
Did you put enough shortening?
I think so.
No worries, let's try again. Just take your time and follow the steps.
I don't know, Sam. Some people aren't cut out for this.
Those people don't own a bakery. Listen to me. You've got my business plan in great shape, so I owe you. And you're not leaving here until you make a solid pie crust. Even if it takes all night.
Deal.
Round two. I didn't realize what time it was. I need to get started on the morning baking.
Thanks for not giving up on me.
No, thank you. I feel like I'm one step closer to not being my mother's employee anymore. Yeah, so we're cutting out.
Yeah.
Dad?
Casey? Dad? And I wasn't about to give up my golf buddy. So, For almost 10 years, we've been sneaking off twice a month to play in Green Point.
We have tried and failed to patch this rift for years.
I don't understand why they won't even hear each other out.
Sometimes an argument takes on a life of its own. So in order to stay out of the mess, we've had to resort to this.
Usually we're here when it's still dark, but I was running late this morning. Lo and behold, we ran into you two, also sneaking around.
Oh, this is not what it seems. we're just helping each other out. This is completely innocent. But you have to keep this a secret.
And that means you can't tell anybody.
You don't tell our secret, we won't tell yours.
Well, let's call them. Well, it's only been a few days since the meeting. I don't want them to think that we're desperate.
I'm just concerned, Casey. Business has never been this slow. We really need this hotel account.
That's why I'm just going to win the bake-off.
Look, now that my foot is better, let me help you with your recipe.
Nope, I'm good, and you are going to love it. I'm pulling out all the stops.
But this is my thing, Casey. I don't know why you won't let me help you.
Because you need to take it easy, and I need to prove to myself and to you that I can do this alone.
What, you don't think I can win, do you?
I never said that. Mom, I made it to the finals on my own.
I know that, Casey, but let's be honest. Baking just...
Don't you think that this place is just as important to me as it is to you?
Yes.
Great. Well, then if you can't support me in this now, then I'll just quit. What? Oh, okay, I'm sorry. I support you.
What happened? Texting you. Did you get my messages?
No, I'm sorry. I've been here by myself all day. I haven't even looked at my phone. It's been one of those days. Why, what's going on?
A friend of mine from culinary school hooked me up with this restaurant group who may be interested in the bakery expansion. I'm doing a tasting tomorrow.
Wow, that's great news, Sam. I'm really happy for you.
I got the call and you were the first one I wanted to tell. Are you okay?
Yeah, I got into a little thing with my mom today, but it's nothing to bore you with.
Well, I have an idea. I want to go out and celebrate the good news, and you look like you need to have some fun. So how about I take you out to dinner?
What happened to not being seen together out in public?
Trust me.
Can I open my eyes yet?
Yeah, we're here.
Okay. I admit it, you got me. I'm impressed. That was delicious and exactly what I wanted. But I need it. Thank you.
I'm sorry to hide us away like this. I just figured it was safer than someone seeing us together in town.
Are you kidding me? This is perfect.
I was thinking about what you said earlier. I think you've more than proven your worth to your mother.
You're probably right. I guess I've come to realize that I'm never going to be here. And to be honest, I don't think I want to be. I want the bakery to succeed, but not at the expense of losing myself.
It's true. I think we both watched our mothers become consumed with work. It's certainly not the way I want to live my life.
Yeah, me neither. And while I love that you're teaching me how to bake, I'm also fine with us simply complimenting each other's skills.
You and me?
Oh, I'm speaking about people as a whole. But sure.
You have to admit, we do make a pretty strong team together.
I don't know. I think the jury's still out on that.
And I'd like to make a suggestion.
You may, but you better keep it brief.
Unfortunately, that may not be possible.
Shh. You and Sam Harper,
why did you just
It just happened.
Casey, if Mom finds out, she's gonna lose it.
Well, she's not gonna find out, is she?
Neither Sam Harper.
Okay, take it easy, okay? And I don't need any more pressure than I already have.
What pressure?
Sam, the business, the bake-off, Mom. It's all just getting a bit too stressful.
Hold it. Is this pressure coming from Mom, or is it coming from you?
Maybe a little bit both.
Mom's worried. Rightfully so. Things are tight right now. But you are putting it on yourself to save this business. It's a family business. It doesn't ride all on your shoulders. Just relax. It's gonna be fine.
God, you and Sam Harper.
Stop. Mom? Dad, what's wrong? Is everybody okay?
I don't get it. We gave them the best this town has to offer.
The hotel?
They just called. We didn't get the account.
Did they say why?
Evidently, someone came in with a lower bid.
To be honest, Casey, I don't think we're going to make it this time.
Need me, I will cancel my tea time.
It's okay, go. I'll be fine.
I'll drive her home.
Okay, thanks, Casey.
I'm sorry. It was all my fault.
Casey, how would you have known someone would come in with a lower bid?
I know, but I was the one who pitched them.
No, honey. This is my fault. I totally mismanaged the business. It wasn't until you joined the company that we even saw the black. Now, Lydia is finally going to get her wish.
It's not over yet. I'm going to win that contest, and I'm going to get us the press that we need to get back on top.
Maybe I shouldn't have pushed you so hard. You don't have to go through with this bake-off if you don't want to.
No. I started this thing, and I'm going to finish it.
Now, do you want to hear my pie recipe or not?
Absolutely.
At home resting for a change. Can I have her call you? Are you okay, Penny?
I was just having a day, and I needed a friend of Murphy's poppy seed muffins.
Oh, well, I can get you one.
Thank you. Every time I come in here, I've always got something going on. You must think I'm so pathetic.
Oh, no, of course not. I'm sorry you're feeling so down. Is there anything I can do for you?
Can I use your restroom?
Of course.
Thanks.
Zucchini, goat cheese, and arugula bruschetta. Bacon-wrapped jalapeno chicken bites. And pepper jack stuffed sourdough pretzels.
It's a very impressive presentation.
So? What do you say?
Your business plan? It's solid. We'll give you that. But 90% of all new restaurants fail within the first year. It's a very competitive field. Which is why we look for establishments which can stand out from all the rest.
So... I mean, something like being featured on a culinary channel?
Exactly. That type of exposure can launch a restaurant, even build a franchise.
You can make something like that happen, we'd be happy to talk about the next step. This is delicious, by the way.
Casey, I just realized I had a little appointment. Tell your mother I'll
come
over later, okay?
Oh, sure, of course. Oh, wait, you forgot your poppy seed muffin.
Thanks for getting together on such short notice.
No problem. I was just teaching my niece how to carve a pumpkin for the festival, but at least she was getting tired of me doing all the carving.
I love those childhood memories.
Yeah. Fall was always my favorite time of year growing up.
So how are things at the Sweet Factory?
Between you and me, not so good. I think there's a real chance for us losing the place, which would break my heart. And my mother's... Who would have thought a pumpkin pie contest would have the ability to alter both of our lives?
Oh, there was some way we could both win.
One pie, one prize. But come on, let's be honest. There's no way I'm going to beat you.
Hey, come on. I'll tell you how to bake. So you never know.
So you think you can show me how to make a bourbon whipped cream?
Well, I was going to perfect my ginger snap streusel crust, but maybe I could be persuaded to multitask.
That sounds like a plan, then. Hello. What was that? I thought you said you guys wanted to be discreet. Was that obvious? Is sharing a steamy glance across the pumpkin tables being obvious? Then, yes, it was. Okay, sorry. I'll be more careful.
Look at Lydia Harper. She's just staring at Mom.
It's kind of sad, really. We're losing such good friends. All three of them. I mean, I wish they would have worked things out.
Can't save everyone, Case.
I'm not trying to save everyone. Okay, maybe a few people.
You know, don't stress about this contest. Just do your best. Things will work out the way they're supposed to. What will be, will be. I'll be right back.
I wanted to do that all day. What do you think I'm doing?
Something my sister said.
What's that?
Everything's gonna work out the way it's supposed to.
Is that clear what happens to us?
I certainly hope so, but all this sneaking around is really making me anxious.
How about this week? Keep our secret for a little bit longer, and then after the bake-off, we'll figure out how to make this work.
Should mind her own business.
I knew it! You are trying to send me to an early grave. He's a Harper, the son of the woman who betrayed me.
Let's not forget that woman used to be your best friend.
Reggie, don't even start. How could you be so naive, Casey, conspiring with the enemy?
The enemy? Mom, please. He's been helping me. He's the one who got me to finals.
Well, then he's got an angle. Harpers always have angles. They're very good at that.
It's been 10 years, Mom. When are you gonna let this go?
Don't you dare turn this around on me, Casey McCarthy. You did this.
Could she be more dramatic?
She just needs to cool off. She'll come around.
No, she won't.
You could be right.
Hundreds of women in this town to choose from, and that's the one you pick?
She's not who you think she is.
She is taking advantage of you, Sam, distracting you from keeping your eye on the prize.
You make her sound like some kind of spy.
Well, I wouldn't put it past her.
I'm sure her mother put her up to this.
Mom. Nothing is more important to me than opening my restaurant. Nothing. Do you really think I'd do anything to jeopardize that?
No.
Where do you see the business plan I've developed? Casey helped me.
So, this whole Casey thing, the strategy? Like, keep your friends close, but your enemies closer.
Well, I
mean... Okay, I like it. All's fair in love and pie, right?
So, a strategy?
That's not exactly what he said. Maybe he was just trying to appease his mother, but it seemed that way anyway.
I tell you right now, he cannot be trusted. That family's motto is win at any cost.
It doesn't make any sense. He seems so...
convincing. Charming. Distracting.
Genuine.
You need to go talk to him.
No, she doesn't.
Yes, she does.
Whose side are you on?
I am on the side of love.
That's the cheesiest thing you've ever said.
Love? You're not in love with that kid, are you?
Mom, it's been less than 2 weeks. No one falls in love that fast.
You think?
Do you have any idea where he could be?
Well, if I had to guess, probably watching the game at O'Malley's.
Then you need to go and talk to him. Mom and I can close up. We can close up.
What are you doing here? People are going to see us.
It doesn't matter. Cat's out of the bag anyway, thanks to Big Mouth Betty.
Yeah, my mom was furious.
Really? Hey, what did you tell her? About me, about us?
I didn't have a chance to explain everything.
Yeah, I know.
My sister overheard your conversation. Something about me being a strategy?
Wait a minute, are you accusing me of something?
No, I'm asking you. Is this some big plot?
Casey, no, she misunderstood me, I swear to you.
And why didn't you correct her then?
My mother could be very irrational when she wants to be. I was just trying to calm her down.
Done the same. Maybe this isn't meant to be.
I know you don't believe that, Casey. We bring out the best in each other. Listen, we've come this far. Our pie recipes are winners, and one of us is going to take this thing home tomorrow. Let's just see it through.
Hey, how come you two are on the local news?
Can we try it out?
Care to share what kind of pie we have to look forward to tomorrow?
Oh, I have invented the most divine pumpkin silk chiffon pie with bourbon whipped cream.
What? That's my pie.
And a ginger snap streusel crust.
That's my crust.
Mm-hmm. Delicious.
Oh, it will be.
The sweet little Betty isn't so sweet after.
So what do we do?
You know what? Working with you this past week, I've realized something very important. Something my mother never understood.
What's that?
You can't create something unique for yourself. You're a partner.
I'm listening.
I'm going to see your mother.
There's no way. Betty would never do something like that. Think about it, Mom. She can never beat you and Lydia, but me and Sam? She saw an opening and she took it.
She thinks she can win with our recipe.
But she's my friend. No, she's not, Mom. She's an opportunist with zero medals under her belt. That's all that matters to her. Well, so now what do? You can't use your recipe and you can't use your pie crust. It's been all over the local news. They'll think you stole it from her. We have a plan. What?
We all need to go see my mom.
Oh. Mom, if you won't do it for the bakery, do it for me.
Long stop. I need to talk to you. It's important.
Lydia, it's about Betty. So, how did Betty get your recipe?
Oh, well, she came into the bakery, and I guess when she excused herself to use the bathroom, she must have seen it on the kitchen counter. It never occurred to me that I should hide it.
Really? I always hide mine in the store safe. As do I. You never know how far the competition will go.
All right, take it easy, you two.
Well, I may have mentioned the ginger snap streusel crust to her at some point, but it's Betty. She's my friend. Well, sometimes friends betray you, so. So, how does this all affect us?
Well, you guys used to spend a lot of time here, baking together.
That's ancient history, honey.
Look, we have a plan, but we need you both on board.
Come on, can you put your differences aside? This is for our businesses.
Yes, but only one of our businesses can win, so.
Not necessarily, but you'll have to trust us. Are you in?
Okay, then. It all starts with one pumpkin pie. We enter as a team. There's nothing in the bylaws that says we can't join forces since we both qualified for the final round.
Which is where you come in. We have 12 hours and we need your help to come up with a pumpkin pie to put all other pies to shame. And no one does that better than you do. This may be long overdue, but I feel I owe you an apology. Lydia, let's just finish helping the kids.
Please, just let me finish. I need to get this off my chest.
I should have fought for you with my father, but I didn't. It's just... You're so good at this, Faye. You've always been better in the kitchen than me. I guess I just didn't want to live in your shadow anymore.
What are you talking about? You've got more bake-off wins than me. You were always prettier and the more popular girl in school. You were never in my shadow. If anything, I was the other way around.
That's where you're wrong. I have always been insecure around you. The only way I was able to beat you all these years was by practically living in the bakery. And that nearly ruined my marriage. In the end, I guess I just wanted to prove to you that I could do it. Well, I wish you hadn't waited 10 years to tell me all that. I never want this to go on as long as it did.
Me neither. But, you know, in some strange way, I think we kind of helped each other.
Sounds like I was the motivation for you to become a better baker, and you certainly motivated me to start my own business.
I'm sorry, Faye.
I'm sorry.
A fresh start?
Absolutely. Now, will you finally give me the recipe for your pumpkin scones?
Let's not get crazy.
Tell me I'm not dreaming.
Nope. Looks like the Cold War's finally ended.
Pumpkin cheesecake pie with a pecan caramel topping. It's perfect. And now you're going to have to recreate it at the festival. And you only get one shot. I have worked out every last detail.
That's what she does.
Okay, guys. Let's do this.
Two of your competitors have decided to compete in the final round as a team.
I don't mean to be difficult, but isn't that against the rules?
That's what I think. So I got it by the contest officials, and you're not going to believe what they say. It's completely legal.
Okay. Right. Well, makes it all the more interesting, right?
It does. That's 60 minutes to bake, and the clock starts now!
Betty has my recipe.
Yeah, I know. You need this already.
No, I need a picture of my actual recipe in my handwriting on tablet.
Wait, so she didn't just copy it yet? She actually took a photo of it?
Yes.
Do you still have your copy of it?
Of course I give it to my pack.
Then we're going to make this a festival they'll never forget.
Down.
Pumpkin cheesecake pie with a caramel pecan topping.
Pumpkin silk chiffon pie with bourbon whipped cream and a ginger snap streusel crust.
One moment. Betty, that sounds amazing. How did you ever come up with a recipe like that?
Oh, I did. Just years of experience, I guess.
Really? Really? And that's your recipe right there on the screen?
Of course.
In your handwriting? That's weird, because I have the same exact one in my handwriting. Could it be that I have the original and you took a photo of it?
Please tell me you're getting all of this.
Yeah, me and about 100 other people.
That's not true.
Is that true, Betty?
No, of course not, Bob. You know me. You all know me.
Then you won't mind doing a handwriting sample for us.
I just wanted to win. One time. Is that too much to ask?
Due to the disqualification, this is the only entry. And you know what that means. Congratulations, Sam Harper and Casey McCarthy. You are the 42nd member of the Lake Shore Champions and Big Baseball Champions.
I'm not sure if you're aware of this, but it's possible if there was a piece in front of the crowd.
Did you make that up, Mr. Harper?
Absolutely, Mr. Harper.
The food is great.
Yeah, we can't complain about the prices.
We're going to have to start charging you, you know. Hurry, we have profits.
Careful, you're starting to sound like your mother.
I'll take that as a compliment.
Yeah. Ah, good choice.
Thank you. Half dozen pumpkin scones, fresh from the oven. Baked by the one and only Olivia Harper. Enjoy.
Not bad, Mrs. Harper.
Not bad at all, Mr. Harper.
October, a time for spooky fun.
Keep your eyes out for ghosts and witches and Cassie!
And an all-new Good Witch.
Welcome to Grey House.
It's gonna be a good show, trust me.
When Halloween is in the air.
Didn't know you were a fan of magic and romance.
Expect the unexpected.
Maybe we can use a little magic.
It's an all-new two-hour Good Witch Halloween event. Premieres next Saturday at 9 on Hallmark Channel, The Heart of Fall.